220 high-powered guns, locked, loaded, and sold to Mexican cartels.
When you're driving through Columbus, it's really a quiet community. There's really not a whole lot going on.
That is until March, when federal agents swarmed Columbus and arrested 11 people, including the mayor, the police chief, and a village trustee. The charge, running guns across the border.
You know, when the mayor and a city councilman and the police chief are involved in smuggling weapons, I mean, that's, come on, you know, geez, how bad can it get?
So bad that federal officials say several guns linked to the trafficking ring have already been found at murder scenes in both Juarez and Palomas. Those guns started in the hands of Blas Gutierrez and several of his family members. Officials say Gutierrez, a village trustee, masterminded the gun-running ring. He's accused of buying hundreds of AK-47s and pistols known as cop killers and smuggling the weapons to the cartels.
The wall that splits Columbus and Mexico is massive, but the people involved in this scheme didn't have to come up with creative ways to get around this wall. Instead, they simply drove through the Columbus port and into Mexico.
The feds tell us the investigation started when officers pulled Gutierrez over and noticed 8 AK-47s in the bed of his truck. They didn't arrest Gutierrez or even confiscate the guns because he bought them legally. But that traffic stop more than a year ago caught the ATF's eye and led to a full-scale federal investigation.
Things like this, as far as I can remember, have been, you know, going on and off.
Meet Roberto Gutierrez. He's Columbus's interim mayor. He also happens to be Blas Gutierrez's father.
In a way, you know, there's some kind of a network or, you know, in a way, kind of like a recruitment.
So they were getting recruited?
That's a very strong possibility.
A possibility that's directly linked to Mexico's strict gun laws. Target 7 has discovered it's practically impossible to buy guns in Mexico. That forces the cartels to recruit gun smugglers on this side of the border.
Did you ever know or have any suspicion about what was going on?
I did, you know, because, you know, the kind of friends, you know, he got involved in, you know, at the end. And I tried to talk to him. It was not, good enough.
You are his father. Other family members were arrested. Did you have anything to do with this?
No, definitely not. Definitely not.
Now, the elder Gutierrez says he wants to help fight the corruption that has forced his family to stare down the barrel of a massive federal investigation.